In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Holy words, long preserved for our walk in this world, they resound.
You are listening to the Goodnight Message with your servant, Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco, on this Saturday, the 17th of August, 2024, broadcasting from the Salesian Pontifical University, Rome, Italy, with this encouraging and strengthening message in line with the first reading of today, entitled, You are not a victim of the past.
Ancient words ever true, changing me and changing you. We have come with all the gods, oh, let the ancient words
in God. In Ezekiel chapter 18, verse 1 to 10, part of the passage that we had today, we find a powerful message of accountability and personal responsibility. This passage illuminates the transformative power of individual choice, freeing us from the shackles of generational sins and past mistakes. God speaks through the prophet Ezekiel, making it clear that each person is judged according to their own actions, not the actions of their ancestors. The word of the Lord came to me. What do you people mean by quoting this proverb about the land of Israel? The parents ate sour grapes and the children's teeth are set on edge. As surely as I live, declares the sovereign Lord, you will no longer quote this proverb in Israel. For everyone belongs to me, the parent as well as the child. Both alike belong to me. The one who sins is the one who will die. Ezekiel chapter 18, verse 1 to 4. In this passage, God dismantles the prevailing belief that one's fate is determined by their parents' sins. This revelation offers a profound sense of empowerment and hope. You are not a victim of your past or the past of others. You are not a victim of your past or the past of others. The Lord calls you to an individual relationship with Him, where your future is shaped by your choices and His grace. Additionally, reflecting on scriptures like 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17 provides further affirmation. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come, the old has gone, the new is here. In Christ, you are granted a fresh start, liberated from the burdens of previous errors or familial shortcomings. This new creation signifies that your identity is now rooted in Christ's redemptive work, not in the failures or sins of the past. Furthermore, Romans chapter 8, verse 1 states, "Therefore, there is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus." This verse underscores the freedom and hope available to you. When you accept Jesus into your life, you are no longer condemned by your past, but are given the opportunity to walk in newness and abundant life. Therefore, let go of the chains of past guilt, failures, and generational curses. Embrace the truth of God's word. You have the power through Christ to break free and journey into a future filled with His promises. Remember, the word says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." Jeremiah 29, verse 11. Trust in these plans and step into the destiny God has meticulously crafted for you. You are not a victim of the past. You are a cherished child of God, destined for greatness. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, Acid Dreams.
Same to you, Father.